Hello, it's Polish Paul VR, and let's do today PSVR news. And let me just tell you, I've been digging and digging and digging very deep. I've got some great news. I digged in places what no human should dig, and I don't mean anus, I mean wars. So we've got a bit of news on abduction, we've got some new releases, some new events, some info about upcoming game what you've been waiting for ages, bit of exclusive from me as well, so let's don't wait and let's begin. Okay, let me start from the Below's VR. This is the game that got announced yesterday. It's like a VR horror experience. You know, it's designed to play as a horror movie. They released it as a demo last year, I think. But then after that, they was like, nah, fuck it, we're gonna make it a full game for free. So it is free now on Steam. I don't know if it's gonna cost anything on PSVR. They do say they might bring a little price tag on it in the future. So I don't know if you're gonna have to pay or not. Alright, so let me give you some brand new news on Abduction. Developers are very silent about the game, but finally they said something. So before I said it, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe, help me grow it. So one of the software engineers at Cyan Interactive will be a speaker at Virtual Reality Developers Conference this fall. And she's done like a Q&A session. And one of her answers, she said that she helped develop the version of the game for desktop Vive and Rift. But she also said that she helped develop soon to be released PSVR and MacVR versions of Abduction as well. Which is great. I'm gonna put link in description to the article. So the game is still being released and apparently it's being soon. So great stuff. Okay, next news, the Fantastic Construction got release date, and that will be coming on 11th of July. The game will have support for PS4 Pro as well as some extra levels exclusive to PlayStation 4. The game will release for $20 with 10% discount for PS Plus members, and the game will run at native 120 frames per second. And PS4 Pro enhancements includes 8 time anti-aliasing, higher resolution textures, improved backdrops and scenery, some extra special effects and extra decorations, as well as 125% resolution oversampling, which means the game will look very sharp. Right, okay, and now the bit of exclusive from me. I always say it's good to be subscribed because sometimes I can give you some great info. And let me talk about the game Dead Secret, which released like in 2015, I think. They announced it for PSVR, but then nothing happened about it. And today they announced a sequel to that game, Dead Secret 2. Basically, Dead Secret is like a horror slash thriller point and click adventure game. It looks pretty interesting, it's had some great reviews. So I decided to reach out to the developers and ask them if the second one will release for PSVR, and they say they do hope so, and they also said they will be releasing first one as well. So there will be Dead Secret and Dead Secret Circle. I don't know if it's gonna be a bundle or like they release one game first and then second, but great stuff. I can't wait for them games. So have a look at trailers. Alright, next news is about the Dreams. Media Molecule just advertised some posts for jobs for them. Two quality assurance controllers, as well as quality assurance technician, which means they are, I think, like reaching the end stages of the game, which is great. In another news, Preta Vendetta Rising went today as an early access on Steam, which is great. They developed the game far enough to like introduce it to public. Probably when it's finished as an early access, it's being released as a full game, you know, on PC and PSVR as well. So let's keep eye on that one as well. And tomorrow or today, depends when this video will upload, let's say 7th of July, go to YouTube or your Little Star Cinema app to experience Durkic VR experience. It's like tie-in with a movie, have a look. Right, okay, and bit of news on Dimension Hunter. If you don't remember, I spoke about it way before E3 happened, actually, and told you, you know, when you can expect the game and that it will have aim controller support as well. But what they did with the game now, they made it so it can be played on arcades, And the arcade is virtualizer arcade system, looks great. It's like a special version of this game, so I think it's gonna be great to see that in action. And as well, new trailer for Cool Painter VR come out. In last trailer they painted sheep, in this one they painted sheep as well, but they paint some waves and some decorations, awesome. Next game, Call of Cthulhu. The developer said it might be coming to VR, PSVR as well. But it all depends on the publisher. So if publisher says, good idea, let's have it in VR, then it will be. Or they might just say, no, fuck it, just no VR. Okay, and bit of news on Flippy's Tesla. The game is very early in developer, but the developers of the game was very rebellious because they let us know some more info about the game. And they said the game is targeted at young audience, about 7-year-old kids, which is just terrible because PSVR not supposed to be used for kids over 12. But never mind, they just been so rebellious and nobody gives a fuck about this rule anyway. Right, and next news, Star Trek The Exhibition in Blackpool in UK. They celebrating the first year anniversary, and what they doing, they gonna let people play Star Trek Bridge Crew on the actual replica of the Enterprise, bridge. So you can play game on the real bridge, but you won't see it because you'll be on in your virtual bridge anyway, but that sounds like a ultimate version of playing the game. And the event will last from 8th till 9th of July. But while we're speaking about Blackpool, there will be Play Expo. That's from 15th till 16th of July. It's like an indie retro game expo. But there will be some VR games as well. There will be PSVR, Vive, Rift, and Microsoft HoloLens. The only game they announced so far is for the Rift, and that will be Duke Nukem, Lucky's Tale, and Doom VR, all in VR, of course. And next information come from Reddit. Reddit user put that Aspyr 1 VR operation, the developers want to bring it into PlayStation VR. It's like a stealth VR game with some great immersion elements to it, so let's keep eye on this game. And just to end, Tekken 7 will be getting DLC, the bowling DLC. But what I'm thinking is, would they bring it to VR? So I went to the DLC actual page. And along all the info, it says that, it's a DLC and shit, and there will be new games mode, but it says as well that the VR might bring discomfort to some users. So I wonder if they're referring to that DLC pack, the bowling game. I hope so. It's just a speculation, it's not a news. Just speculating about it. But we shall see. So that will be it from me now. Thanks to everyone who subscribed. And if you like the video, then hit like and subscribe as well. And I'll be back.